After examining rotations 1, 2, and 3, time has come to look also into rotation 4. What is happening in rotation 4 on a volleyball court? The setter starts from position 4 and in this rotation should cover bigger distance to the place where he should set the ball than in other rotations. The middle blocker starts from position 3. Maybe the greatest specifics of this rotation is that the outside hitter first row in position 2 spikes from position 4 in order to leave space for the opposite 3 in position 1 to attack from back row. It is typical for this rotation that the opposite can join the receiving formation and the team can receive with 4 people, especially against a hard serve. In this way, the gaps between the receivers get shorter and this simplifies the efforts of the libero and the outside hitters. In terms of attack, this rotation is not suitable for a spike of the middle behind the back of the setter unless the reception is moved towards position 4, but allows the setter freely to play with the middle at a distance or behind, or with the middle close in front and over him in position 4. The outside hitter back row is in the middle of the receiving formation, which simplifies the pipe attack. In terms of reception, the weakest point is between the outside hitters in position 5 and position 6. The opponent can try to isolate the first row attacker by serving at him. When doing so with a serve from position 1 to position 5, it is harder for the other outside hitter to help because the ball covers less distance. The libero is in position 1 and against the float serve can cover the right half of the court and the other two receivers the left half. It is also possible that the team can receive in certain situations with only 2 players.